This is the rifle conversion kit for the Umarex HP50, or in my case the NXG PS100, which is the exactly same model as the HDP50, only with 11 Joule in tungsten gray, which was not available as black version and was the strongest version in my country back then when it came out. When I first saw this conversion kit, my first thought was if it will improve the power of the gun in joules that it delivers. And I saw a video where it was shown that that isn't really the case. So I was very curious if it's possible to mod it in a way that the power that comes out of the gun is increased. And spoiler alert, it's possible and I did it. My thoughts were, if the gun goes in here and it's possible to close this gap between the barrel and the conversion mod, it should increase the power as no air can go out here. And another thing I recognized in another video was that the diameter of this barrel inside is larger than the diameter of the original barrel in the gun. So when the ball flies into the conversion kit, there is a space and the air can just move everywhere and doesn't push the ball anymore. So I had the idea of insert a new barrel inside the mod and somehow fix it with this thread on the front. There's also a tuning barrel for the gun, which I've ordered already, but I wanted to test it before with the plane gun and make a mod for the plane gun to increase it, as I think many have the stock version of this gun with 7.5 joule because of regulations and perhaps not modded, and this is just an easy click in mod for more power when plinking. And yeah, so how did I accomplish that? First of all, I found a pipe. This is a stainless steel pipe that fits inside the barrel of the conversion mod, and it's the same diameter on the inside as this original barrel in the gun. I'll link it in the description below that you can get the right barrel. And this just slides in here, and then I've designed two pieces. The one goes onto this barrel and it can't pass through, as this barrel here is, I can show it to you without the mag, it's a bit moving. So it shouldn't be too tight that this barrel can't move, or you will get some kind of malfunction in the gun. And yeah, so this piece here just sits on the barrel and it goes in here and closes the gap to the gun, and it doesn't let the barrel, the new barrel, through. And I'll show it on the actual 3D model. It's a bit widened here, so if there's not aligning the edges of the barrel and the bridge piece are not perfectly aligned, that the ball won't be stopped or slowed down by the edge. So this piece is just stuck on the barrel and mounted in the front. of the conversion kit. So when this piece is inside, it's fixated by the gun, and as you see, there isn't really a clearance here, so that perfectly holds. And with some screws, the gun is then fixated in here, but I spare this step for now and show you the mod. And now we have this ugly long piece that comes on the front here. Why did we make this long piece? Because it's the original length of the barrel, and I wanted to test it before shorten the barrel, and then I have a barrel a bit too short, and yeah, must buy another one. And why did I print it in white? Because I like prototyping in white, as I can mark any comments on the prototypes itself, and then when everything is done, I print it in black. This can be screwed on the front of the conversion kit, and then you see the barrel rests inside here and is fixated by the light, a bit smaller diameter on the front, so that the new barrel can't move and there is no gap where air can leave the gun. So far so good, that's my idea, and then I will show you the on the Joules that it had. I will also make a shorter version here that can be threaded all the way through and has the narrow diameter here on the front, so that you can saw the pipe to the exact length and then just have a little cap that's not that ugly. Or yeah, or perhaps I can design something that looks like a silencer, that would be probably cool, but in this way it looks a bit odd. And of course, if someone has the tuning barrel installed, which I will do too, it again shifts the metal pipe and will change the effective length of the pipe that will be needed. So I made my first iteration of the mod in the way that I don't shorten the pipe. So these are the iterations of the parts in Tinkercad. This was pretty easy once I had the thread tested that it worked, and this is just the end piece with a little smaller diameter on the front that the additional barrel pipe doesn't slip through, and then it was only too connected with a long ring. So that was pretty much easy forward designing. And I will also cut out this piece so this sits on the thread directly for shortened barrels, that it's not necessary to have such a long piece in the front of the conversion kit. More challenging was this piece here. This was my first non-rectangular trial, as the rectangular didn't work. I just stacked some rings where this one goes into the conversion kit, and the barrel of the gun, or the front of the gun, rests on this side. Yeah, I made a higher version with just one ring and a bit shorter version. I also tried to make some space for a rubber ring, but I don't think it's really necessary, as there's also a bit of space between chamber and barrel, but yeah, of course the tighter the better. So this is the final version, and what I did is I made the entry hole a bit wider, so the gun is here underneath, and when the ball comes into this piece and the edges are not completely aligned, it's no problem here, because by widening this hole, the ball has a smooth entry and no edge where it can be slowed down. Yeah, and the barrel itself, the pipe,
rests on this ring, so the ball can enter the additional barrel without a problem. And when screwing in, you don't have to fear that the additional barrel comes into the gun, because as the original barrel of the gun is a bit moving too, they shouldn't make any contact if you screw the front piece too hard, so that the new barrel goes into the gun. The original barrel wouldn't have any place to move, and so I keep them separate.
So these are the prototypes I made. First I tested, of course, the thread, and I like prototyping with white PLA, because I can write versions and diameters and such things on it. Then I tested the barrel extension in different ways, and also here the cap where the barrel sits that it doesn't slip through the different blocks between the conversion kit and the front of the gun. And yeah, so that's my process of iterations. I always do little adaptations and mark it until I reach the point where I'm satisfied with the final product. This is my test setup. Here is the chronograph I bought for this test, and I'll shoot this curtain so the bullets drop down into the box, hopefully. Be sure to wear safety glasses when testing such short distances or in general. And behind this curtain there is a cardboard box, so I won't damage anything that's behind this curtain. First we start with a 3D printed sling hammer and an 80-pound EK archery bow. The device is set to feeds per second. The next test is the Umarex HDR 50, or in this case the NXG PS 100 version. It's the 11 Joule version, and we shoot three rubber balls and three rubber coated steel balls. These have 1 gram and this weight 5 gram. Now I just punch the stock, and this indicator shows that now there's pressure in the weapon. Now the rubber steel balls are coming. Now we're going to test the conversion kit without the mod, and I changed my setup to shoot in a cardboard box with a towel inside, as I already penetrated my curtain. Thank you. So this is now the next iteration of the mod, now with the part that doesn't let the barrel slip through, and with the part shortened so that it creates some contact or tension with the barrel, with the additional barrel. Here's the part probably most of you came for, the table with the measured differences in speed and power. Out of the box, the gun delivers what it says, on the box. The coated steel balls deliver more energy as they are heavier, and please note that the distance from gun to chronograph was only 1 meter, so the heavier projectile's energy will decrease faster over distance than the lighter projectile's. A very interesting fact is that the conversion kit alone already increases speed and energy due its longer barrel, although not as much as it could due to the too large diameter of the barrel in the conversion kit. My mod increases the speed and energy even further, but works much better for the rubber balls than for the coated steel balls. First, I was a bit disappointed, but I already have an assumption. The coated steel balls are a lot more sticky than the rubber balls, so probably they are causing more friction in the barrel. In addition, they are probably a bit larger due to the welding notch of their coating. An effect that is barely measurable for the short barrel of the gun, but gets more recognizable with a longer barrel. I'll get some steel or aluminium balls and redo the test with them, and I'm pretty sure that they will benefit much more from the mod to less friction. I will link all the files in the description below. Please be aware of your local laws before modding any weapons, also non-lethal weapons, airsoft guns or CO2 guns. In the next step, I redesigned the front cap to look more like a moderator and also give it some functionality, but it only decreased the sound around 2 decibel in the first try, while keeping the energy at the level of the modded conversion kit. I did this mod to see if I could increase the power for more accuracy while plinking, and not only to have an optical or haptical conversion. And of course, because I simply love tinkering. But what do you think about this mod? Does it add something to the conversion kit, or is it completely unnecessary? I'm curious, so please leave a comment if you want. Thank you for watching the video, and have fun making.